Flow is a place where we bring in knowledge, fitness, food, organics, everything together. It is one platform where we want to promote healthy living. So, my first questions for you first. So, in today's lifestyle, what is your fitness mantra and what is the routine which you follow?
I basically do a lot of yoga, pranayam, meditation, and gym. So I have a combination of all these things, plus eating right. For me, a combination of eating right, doing physical exercise, plus internal exercise, which is meditation. For me, all that is very important to align the body, mind, and spirit.
Okay. And when you say eating right, what is it that you in particular follow? Is there anything which you would like to share with us?
See, basically, I like eating everything, but I do watch my food habits and I eat healthy stuff. Like if I want to eat, I eat eggs, I eat protein, I eat nuts, I eat a lot of fruit, I have a lot of fluids. So all that combines together, and if I have to choose, I'd rather choose a healthy option rather than an unhealthy option. Though I would say that I do binge on a lot of sweets because that's my weakness. But yes, I do watch my food as often as I can. And I eat a lot of fiber, which is jawar, bajra, brown rice. So all these things are healthier options rather than eating something which is fried, or I don't eat a lot of junk. I don't eat junk food at all, actually, not even a lot. I don't have packaged food as far as possible unless it's really healthy. So I try and eat as much natural food as possible.
We are talking about food here. What is your understanding about organic food? How would you, suggest that to others, the viewers?
So, like I said, that natural food is very important. In fact, as we are here, you know, if you can grow some of the stuff that you can, like vegetables or little things that you can grow, it is better than, you know, eating from outside. So I would prefer it if you get organic food or source it from somewhere where you can get, like from a village, if you can get your rice or your bajras and your jawars and everything, if you can source that, nothing like it. But if you can't, just choose your food correctly and eat it right.
Madam, what is your opinion about fitness? What is your fitness routine in your daily life?
Firstly, I have to thank you for being here. I have to thank Sangeetha for being part of this wonderful initiative that we have, which is this walkathon for sponsoring children from Ashwini Charitable Trust to become part of the teacher training program that will be introduced for the first time in Bangalore from Krishnamachari Yoga Mandira, Chennai. And that for us is such an honor and a privilege, because Krishnamachari Yoga Mandira is an institution which is 40 years old, and it is one of the only yoga schools in India which is ISO 9000 certified as late as 2015. And their foundation is tradition and research. So we're so honored to have Sangeetha to promote this wonderful cause, and the children are coming for the walkathon tomorrow, and we're really, really excited about it. So as you can see, that yoga is a part of my life, and practice of yoga is a part of my life. And yoga is not just about the physical practice, it's actually a way of living. And so one of the elements is the physical practice, and as she mentioned, pranayama and chanting, meditation, all of it, and a way of life. From the way you, from the time you get up to the way you, when you go to sleep, it's how you speak, what are the actions you take in the day. Everything combines together for a way of life which is related to yoga. And being a classical Indian dancer, a Bharatanatyam dancer, we also have dance classes here. So that is also part of my fitness regime. I recently went to Everest Base Camp and I just came back 10 days ago. So that was an amazing experience for me. So a combination of physical, spiritual, and mental and emotional well-being, as well as food, which is so important, as Sangeetha ji rightfully pointed out. All of that together is something that we all try to maintain every day.
What is your opinion about food, organic food in particular?
I'm actually sattvic in my way of food, and I've been practicing this now for many years. And I've got to say, it's completely transformed the way I look, and it itself has helped my body become fully regimented. So my diet is extensively simple. Many a times I don't even eat chapati and rice. I literally live on paneer and vegetables and milk. And I'm also a sweet buff, a chocolate buff. And so that's my weakness. like Sangeetha was mentioning. And this Sattvic way of life for me has truly changed the way I look and the way I feel internally and externally. And so obviously organic food, I'm very blessed to have this very beautiful place in Maleshwaram. So a lot of our greens and our vegetables are grown at home. My mother is a wonderful gardener and a maintainer of this entire beautiful garden that we have. So a lot of our pudina and coriander and spinach and our carrots are all grown at home. So I'm very honored for that, and I do believe the only way is organic. And you know, if each one of us try to make an effort in our own kitchen gardens, in our balconies possibly, and a lot of terrace gardens are coming up today to encourage organic way of living. It's going to be taking a bit of a process, but I'm sure it will be leading to a healthier way of life.
Your center focuses on yoga. So what can you share about, what is the experience, your training, your certifications, which you can share with us?
The beautiful part of this is that we conduct holistic and integrated yoga practices. We have wonderful teachers that have been taught with various practices, Ashtanga, Vinyasa and Hatha Yoga. And together we have combined this form to bring a holistic experience of well-being for our people. Now with the Krishnamacharya Yoga Mandira 500 hour teacher training program, which is internationally considered as one of the best teacher training programs, all our teachers will also be trained teachers from there. And therefore, I do believe the practice will only be more focused, more beneficial for the yoga practitioners who come to our center.
And when it comes to yoga, what do you suggest a person should do thrice a week or every day? How is it like generally?
You know, after I answer this question, I think you should ask Sangeetha about her yoga practice, because she's practiced for more number of years than me. As I said, yoga is a way of life. This is not something you practice 1 hour a day for 3 days a week and forget it. As you know, in Patanjali Sutra, you have Ashtanga Yoga, which is the eight rules of yoga. And Yama Niyama is one of the most essential elements of life, which is rules for myself and rules which we follow for the rest of the world. So yoga is a daily living practice of life. That is how it started. But today yoga's focus is only on asana practice. And so that asana practice is, you know, you're restricted to 1 hour a day or 2 hours a day or, you know, 3 hours, I mean 1 hour a day or, you know, thrice a week or one, you know, seven or whatever. So for me, if it's a physical practice, most certainly you should at least try to fit in 3 times a week. And as a concept, bring in the other elements of yoga, like meditation, dhyanam, yama, niyama, all of those aspects, which will make it a very holistic well-being for ourselves.
What about your opinion on yoga being practiced?
For me, yoga is a way of life, just like she says, because it's not just a way of life, it's a part of me. For me, I can't think of any other way of being but the way it is right now. You know, yoga is very important because yoga, pranayama, meditation, these things are very essential. We've had these for centuries. But what we do is we go looking for things outside our country when we have everything right here in our country. So I do feel that it's very important, first of all, for everybody to know that what we have here is the most fantastic thing you can ever think of. So please do try it. It is very, very essential for your mind, body and spirit. Coming to your question, yes, it is a way of life for me. It is a part of my being. It is a part of my practice. Because what yoga, pranayama and meditation does is it doesn't just change you the way you look or the way you feel. It does help in your appearance. It is also anti-aging. It is proven scientifically that meditation slows down the aging process. So I would like to tell all my viewers that they must try it, and that's my secret perhaps. And another thing is that what meditation does to you, the whole lead of following up to pranayama yoga meditation, what it does to you, it doesn't just change you externally, it changes you internally, it changes you mentally, it changes you emotionally, physically, psychologically and spiritually, of course, you grow. So when you align all these three things together and you sit and you meditate, it transforms you and you transcend to a beautiful space which cannot be expressed in words, trust me, because it is so magical. So you have to do it. It is a beautiful way of life.
How does music and dance help in fitness?
Music is essential part of it, as they say, sound. Sound is, we start with Om. Om is the universal sound, and that's how we've begun. So music is a part of everybody's being, irrespective of whether they want to hear it or not hear it. But at some point, everybody needs to get aligned with music, because whatever mood you are in, you listen to that kind of music, and that really helps in relieving yourself, releasing yourself, or feeling happy. There are so many moods that get attached to the music. So music is a part of everybody's life. And as far as dance is concerned, dance can't happen without music. So it goes hand in hand, of course. It goes without saying, because the movement of the body and the sound, it aligns with each other.
There's one question which we would like to ask. What is your opinion about belly dancing, which is actually becoming very popular these days?
I have tried a bit of belly dancing. I won't say I'm trained in it, but I think it's wonderful if they can practice it. It is an interesting way of being, and it kind of, the rhythm and the movement that they do, it is very beautiful. I've seen them perform, so I think it's wonderful the way they do it. It is very attractive to watch as well. It is very entertaining as well, and it's a great exercise as well for the core. So I think it's wonderful if you can try it.
Now, what about your opinion?
I have been trained as a classical Bharatanatyam and a Kuchipudi dancer since a very young age of 8, and continue to practice that. So for me, that is what connects me to, and most of our dances are about Lord Krishna or Lord Shiva. So my connection to Lord Krishna and Lord Shiva and all the other experiences of the Lords with dance is complete with my Bharatanatyam. So for me, that is for me everything. So every form of dance is a connection and an exhilaration. So everything is absolutely beautiful.
Zumba, cycling, there are so many things people are getting on to these days. So any inputs?
I think cycling is a fantastic way of exercising. In fact, I just met a doctor recently who advised that to my father, and he said, you know, it helps in arthritis. So that is really wonderful if people cycle. I have enjoyed cycling. In school, I used to be the champ in cycling. And as far as Zumba is concerned, I have tried it with my friends. And I think these are all wonderful forms of exercise, because exercise in itself is very important for the body. You can't just have your body stuck and, you know, you just sit all the time, because there has to be movement, just like you need to drive your car all the time. So this is also your vehicle, because if you keep your car parked and never use it, it's going to corrode and it's going to rust. So just like that, your body will also just become jammed and it will start creaking. So you have to move it. So exercise, Zumba, aerobics, whatever form of exercise you can do. Because for me, I do a lot of intense gym exercises, weight bearing exercises, I do a lot of cardio exercises, I swim a lot. So for me, all these are very, very important and a part of my life.
When it comes to yoga, how yoga and women's health, what is your input on that?
See, I'm a businesswoman. I basically run a financial advisory company. And, you know, being a woman, I also have other responsibilities of my home, my family, etc. So at the end of the day, I need to take care of myself physically, mentally, and emotionally for me to be able to do all of the things that I want to do as a woman. And that is not just special for me, it is for all of us women. So keeping that in mind, I do believe that yoga and yoga practices must become part of every woman's daily life from a very young age, so that helps her build her physical strength, her mental strength, and finally her emotional strength to be able to do all of the things that she wants to do. And also, life is going to bring about a lot of challenges for us, and that is part of everybody's life. And this kind of a practice regularly actually builds the foundation for physical, mental, and emotional strength to be able to actually handle everything in a very balanced manner. Because finally, yoga talks about a very important element called samasthiti. Everything will have to find its balance. There can never be too much of high and too much of low. It will find a samasthiti in life. So only if we have a balanced way of life, which is what nutrition talks about, which is what everything actually talks about, can this be done. And yoga is the best practice to bring about this samasthiti, especially for a woman, because we are constantly parallel processing multiple things. And that is so, so critical for a woman.
And as a wellness center, Krishna Wellness Center, do you have any programs, especially for women, corporates? Do you have any programs?
We are going to be introducing all of it now. We already have Bharatanatyam dance classes here for more senior students. We have workshops over here. We are going to be bringing in a lot more very, very interesting workshops. We already have kacheris here. We've had the Tirusur brothers come and sing at our place. We've had Purandara Nam Kirtana by Srimati Pushpa Anand. We are going to have the Chelikeri brothers come and chant here on International Yoga Day on June 21st. So this is not just, it's about you know, preserving and supporting our wonderful traditional Indian culture. So this center showcases all of it. So we're going to have constantly very interesting programs for all Bangaloreans to come and enjoy and also support several causes, like what we're doing tomorrow with our walkathon. And again, so honored to have Sangeetha come all the way from Bombay and make time for that event. For us, it really is very, very special.
So, about tomorrow's walkathon, what is your feel? What is your comment on it?
I think it's wonderful. What Mimi is doing is amazing. She's not just having a walkathon, which is again a healthy way of being. So, we are having a great walk, but it's also supporting a charitable trust, the Ashwini Charitable Trust, and empowering these children and training them for a teacher's training program. She's you know. Financing that, and she's going to help them in empowering themselves to be able to do something in life. So I think that's fantastic to, you know, convert them into teachers and, you know, pull the students out and teach them something so beautiful, which I was telling everybody that we have it in our country, but they don't want to learn it. You know, what happens is the West goes there and picks it all up and then it packages it back to us. So I think that's a shame, because, you know, you have it here, so use it. So, you know, when she's going to empower these children by training them and, you know, they become independent, what more can you ask for? I think it's a wonderful way if each one can do something in their little way to, you know, to bring people and help them and support them and empower them. I think this country is going to move well.
Finally, any tips and suggestions for viewers, readers?
Well, I feel it, like she said, and I also feel that you need to have a balanced and healthy life, and with yoga, pranayama, meditation, exercise, eating right. It all has to align together. I know it's not easy for everybody to do it because it's very time consuming and nobody wants to give that much time. But I do feel that in 24 hours, if you can give even that 1 hour to yourself, I think it would be worth it if you can do all these practices and give yourself a little more attention, love yourself a little more. I think that's very important.
Ma'am, you are influence on this.
Again, I'd like to thank everybody for supporting this 5K walkathon. So many people have come together, so many yoga schools have come together, so many eminent personalities of Bangalore, as you can see in our eminent chief guest and list. Everybody's come together to support this cause and also to revere the late Sri Krishnamacharya, who is considered as the father of modern yoga, who was the teacher of B.K. Sangar and Sri Patabi Joyce. So the idea is to revere somebody who actually resurrected yoga and brought yoga to us in this form that it exists today and spread it across the world. So two beautiful elements, revering Sri Krishnamacharya and also, you know, walking for a cause, which is to raise funds to get one, or, you know, to get these students to become certified as the internationally best known yoga teachers with this teacher training program. So I cannot be, I mean, more grateful, and I feel so blessed that so many people have come together, so many yoga schools have come together to support this cause. So I feel extremely blessed, and as I can say to viewers, please always have yoga in your life for a balanced and beautiful life, and that will always bring definitely benefits to you through your life. It's not something that you just practice for 1 or 2 or 3 hours a week, but it should become a way of life for you.
Thank you so much for your time and your valuable
input.
I think this will really go a long way for our viewers and readers.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for coming. Thank you.